Hariyam friends, welcome once again to my Sanatan Duniya channel, your spiritual home. In this video, I shall be giving my commentary upon verses 20 to 25 of the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. For those of you who have not yet watched the introduction to the Bhagavad Gita and the commentaries on the previous verses of the first chapter of the Gita, I suggest you go ahead and watch these videos before proceeding further with this video. These videos are available in the playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary, All 18 Chapters. Before I go ahead and give the commentary to these verses of the first chapter of the Gita, I have a small request to make. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. So let's move on. The 20th to 23rd slokas of the first chapter of the Gita are as follows. O King, at that time Arjuna, the son of Pandu, who was seated in his chariot, his flag marked with Hanuman, took up his bow and prepared to shoot his arrows, looking at the sons of Dhritarashtra. O King, Arjuna then spoke to Rishikesha, Krishna, these words. Arjuna said, O infallible one, please draw my chariot between the two armies so that I may see who is present here, who is desirous of fighting and with whom I must contend in this great battle attempt. Let me see those who have come here to fight, wishing to please the evil-minded son of Dhritarashtra. The commentary to the above three slokas is as follows. In the 20th verse, we find a mention of Lord Hanuman here. It states that the chariot of Arjuna bore the flag of Hanuman on it. There is a significance and reason to it. Hanuman is an avatar of Lord Shiva and is known for his power and might. He had a strong body and is worshipped by all the Kshatriyas in particular so that they may also acquire a similar mighty strength by being devoted to Lord Hanuman. Even in today's world, we find that many people who have to carry heavy weights as part of their jobs or even once in a way utter Jai Bajrang Bali. This is done to invoke the mighty strength of Hanuman, which enables the concerned people to lift the heavy weight or luggage or carry out the concerned hard physical task in hand. So we find here that Arjuna, being an ideal Kshatriya, gives his respect to Lord Hanuman by having his emblem on a flag in his chariot. In the above three slokas, we find Arjuna requesting Lord Krishna, his charioteer and friend, to take his chariot in between the two armies so that Arjuna can have a closer look at whom he has to fight with in battle. No matter how much mental preparation and batting in the nets a cricket batsman might do, he can have a clear idea of the opponents he has to face only when he enters the field in order to bat in the midst of expectant crowds watching the game. Similarly, Arjuna could have a clear idea of whom he has to fight with and how to prepare himself for the combat only when he comes face to face with the opposing armies. And hence, we find here that Arjuna requests Lord Krishna, his charioteer, to take him to the midst of the two armies, which signifies that he wants to be in the midst of action. Now I shall move on to slokas 24 and 25. The 24th and 25th slokas of the first chapter of the Gita are as follows. Sanjaya said, O descendant of Bharata, being thus addressed by Arjuna, Lord Krishna drew up the fine chariot in the midst of the armies of both parties. In the presence of Bhishma, Drona and all other chieftains of the world, Rishikesha, the Lord said, just behold Partha, all the Kurus who are assembled here. The commentary of the above two slokas is as follows. Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna, the Supreme Lord of the creation, had in the beginning of creation created the four Varnas or castes of human society. The four Varnas or castes are, first one, Brahmana or priest caste. Second, Kshatriya or administrator and warrior caste. Third, Vaishyas or traders and merchants caste. And fourth, Shudras or servants caste. The duty of the Shudra or servant caste is to render the necessary service to the three higher castes in a meek and obedient manner. A charioteer, for example, should obey his master's orders and take the chariot wherever the master orders him to do so. So here we find that Lord Krishna, who is the Lord of creation, after having gladly accepted the role of a charioteer of his friend Arjuna's chariot, is being instructed by Arjuna to take his chariot between the two armies. After having received this order from Arjuna, Lord Krishna, like a humble and obedient servant, takes the chariot of Arjuna between the two armies. All of us have a lesson to learn from the divine friendship and relationship between Lord Krishna and Arjuna. Firstly, if Lord Krishna wanted, he could have appointed somebody else to be the charioteer of Arjuna. But here we find that Lord Krishna himself happily accepting the role of a charioteer. This just reflects how humble and kind-hearted the Lord is. Similarly, even these days we find that there are still a few very big and important people of society who, despite their achievements and laurels, still accept small and menial roles in the ashrams of their gurus, such as cleaning the floors and walls of the ashram, cooking prasad for the devotees, serving prasad in the kitchens, and rendering all sorts of pious activities in various capacities in the ashrams of their gurus. This is a very nice way of humbling the ego and remaining grounded in life despite one's laurels and achievements in society. So friends, here ends the commentary on the 20th to 25th verses of the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Stay tuned for more commentaries on the following slokas of the Gita and keep checking this channel for updates to this playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary, All 18 Chapters. And also, do watch the other videos available in this channel so that you can enhance your knowledge of the eternal religion or Sanatana Dharma. And in case you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so, so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time ahead. Hari Om.